Yeah.
Sit without a problem on the organ.
This is a Dan Garland organ, 26 ranks. People ask me, is it a good organ? I'll tell you, it is a wonderful organ. He said, Dan Garland has said it is his favorite, and he has built, I don't know how many organs, but many. And of the ones he built, and it's well made, well constructed, and so it is a thrill. It's a joy for me to play it. I enjoy it thoroughly. Katie, I've known for many years, and she studied first with Becky Ward, who is the organist at First Presbyterian, and then she went to Baylor and studied with Joyce Jones and also Isabel Demers to get her undergraduate degree at Baylor, during which time she served as the organist here at Central Christian. So it's like a friend coming back home for her. And then she left us to go to Alabama, to the University of Alabama, and just completed her Master of Music there, studying with Faith Freeze. She is now currently teaching, and my paper was to help me remember the town, Thomasville, United Methodist Church in Thomasville, Alabama, and also teaches in the elementary school in Thomasville, Alabama. So, Katie, we welcome her. Would you all help me welcome back Katie back home?
It's a big book. It's kind of weird because it has like some
treatise sections in it, so it's also a treatise on how to compose pieces. So that's just a small sampling of this huge book that we have from 16th century Poland of all places. The next thing I'm going to play is the Trio Sonata No. 4 by Johann Sebastian Bach. Bach wrote 6 trio sonatas. A trio is, well, basically when your right hand is doing one thing, your left hand is doing another thing, and your feet are doing something entirely different. They are not easy to play. In fact, Bach wrote them as teaching pieces for his eldest son, probably because he both loved the boy and wanted to make it really hard for him. You know, he's a Bach, there's high standards for him to live up to, I'm sure. So these days we still play them, but it's usually given to college students. Give them something hard to do, so we don't get too cocky. So here's the Trio Sonata No. 4 by Bach.
Thank you.
too much of his music today. And I'm going to play some of it because today's his birthday. He was born today in 1664. And this is a partita on my favorite German chorale, von Gott, nicht, lassen. For those of you who don't know German, that text translated to English means from God can nothing move me. So after this piece, I'm going to take some time to change my general pistons. This organ doesn't have multiple memory levels, it just has one. And so I had to program a whole recital with just 10 different general pistons. For those of you who aren't organists, that just means that after this next piece, I'm going to need a break to push some buttons for my next few pieces. So after this, just sit tight, be patient, we'll continue with the program.
Thank you.
particular one begins with a set of chorale variations, followed by a fugue. And the finale, which you would normally expect to be very loud and boisterous at the end of your typical sonata, it's actually pretty soft. So when I play the soft piece and I get off the bench, it's because I'm done. I didn't leave anything out. That's actually how it's supposed to end. I have to push some more buttons for this, so bear with me. This is the last break I need to take to set pistons. Thank you.
Thank you.
broke my toe. And I still had a couple of organ lessons left. And Dr. Freeze, being the professional she was, she's like, nope, we still have a couple lessons. You still have to learn something. You still have to bring it to your lessons, even though you have to wear this big, ugly this walking boot for 2 weeks. I had to wear a walking boot for 2 weeks. So I couldn't play pedals. And I needed something to play for my lessons, just manuals only. So I dug out this collection of pieces that I bought a few years earlier. It's the 12 short pieces by contemporary Canadian composer Rochelle Laurent. And her style is pretty quirky. She writes kind of like Langlais. And this is manuals only. Again, it's what I learned when I broke my toe.
Thank you.